Good morning, students. Today we are having the continuation of grammar from Grammar and More for 8th class. First chapter, sentences. We have already in the last two videos learned about the kinds of sentences. Affirmative and negative sentences. I also explained about yes or no questions and WH questions. Once again, we shall begin with yes or no questions. In interrogative sentences, the questions can be asked in two ways. Some questions can be answered with yes or no. These kind of questions will be beginning with a helping verb. For example, can you help me with my chart? Answer can be given in yes or no. Yes. Has Monal finished his maths project? No, she hasn't. Did Rani speak to the manager on the phone? Yes, she did. So all these questions, three examples we saw, they begin with a helping verb. And for these questions, we can give the answer in yes or no. Such questions are known as yes or no type questions. Now, we also ask questions for getting information. So, information seeking questions, they begin with question words like what, which, when, where, why, and how. All these question words have a common letters in that W and H. So these questions means information seeking questions beginning with the question words are generally known as WH questions. WH questions. They cannot be answered in yes or no. Instead, we should give the information sought through these questions. So, interrogative sentences are of two types, yes or no type of questions beginning with helping verb and WH questions beginning with question words. Yes or no type questions can be answered in yes or no. Whereas WH questions seek information and it cannot be answered in just yes or no, but we should provide information for these questions. This is about WH questions or yes or no type question. Now, in the questions, there is one more thing, question tags. Question tags are attached to a statement. We make a statement and for confirmation, confirmation of what we made in the statement. For that, we add a short, very short question containing a verb, usually auxiliary verb, and a subject. For that, that will be after a comma, we place the short question at the end of the sentence. Such questions are known as question tags. For example, you will remember to finish the work. And the tag is won't you. You will remember to finish the work, comma, won't you. This is question tag. Question tags are not asked for any confirmation or get an answer in yes or no. It is just to assert or affirm what we said or what we said in the statement. In order to confirm it, we make the short question at the end of the sentence. So the question tags will not be placed alone. For example, a statement is given to you and you are asked to form a question tag. Then should not make a verb with a verb and a subject, just a short question and give us answer. You should write the complete sentence, the statement, and instead of a full stop, place a comma at the end and then give the tag question. So the question tags are, as we said, usually contain a helping verb and a subject. And the helping verb and subject must be the same helping verb and the subject used in the statement. We cannot use any helping verb or any subject as we like. The same helping verb and the same subject in the statement should be given in the question tag also. And another thing the important thing to remember is, if the statement is an affirmative sentence, then the question tag will be negative. And for a negative statement, an affirmative question tag will be there. For an affirmative statement, negative question tag will be there. And for a negative statement, we place an affirmative question tag. So that's why the example we already saw. You will remember to finish the work, an affirmative statement. And the question tag is negative, won't you? Another example for affirmative statement, Shalini is going to the zoo with her mother. And the question tag is, isn't she? Negative. Then for negative statement, we will have affirmative question tag. Pritha won't miss her train. Will she? Pritha won't miss her train, a negative statement. And the question tag, will she, is affirmative. This fan isn't working, negative statement. And the question tag is it, affirmative question tag. And about the subject, one more thing. Say, in the first example of the negative statement, Pritha is the subject, it's a noun. But if the subject is a noun, we should use a proper pronoun for it in the question tag. Question tag, we will not use a noun as the subject. Instead, a proper pronoun should be used in the question tag. Pritha is the name of a female. So we use she as pronoun for females. So instead of will Pritha, we made the tag question as will she. Then next sentence example, This fan isn't working. This fan is the subject. So it's an inanimate object. So we use it as pronoun for the noun. So the question tag is it? So that while making a question tag, we should remember the points in our mind is for a affirmative statement, the question tag will be negative. For a negative statement, the question tag will be affirmative. And we should use the same auxiliary verb and the subject in the question tag which we used in the statement. And in the question tag, instead of a noun, we should use a proper pronoun. This is all about interrogative questions and question tags. Thank you everyone for watching the video. I hope you liked it. Thank you.